Let me tell you, between you and I think the show's a little bit boring. We need to spice it up a bit. You know what I'd really like to do? Water pistols.
Yeah. Get them all going. Squirt the gas.
Teasers.
You know, most of the show actually happens here. This is where the fun part happens. So do you know the key to a bloody brilliant life? Have as much fun as you can have every second. It's not what I do in front of the camera there. In front of the camera, behind there, in front of the camera. It's what goes on a day-to-day basis. Looking at your attitudes, your beliefs, how you eat. More coffee. More beer. That's what it's all about. So a bloody brilliant life is what you make. It's what you think about every day when you wake up. And think about making your life perfect, making it brilliant. Sure, you go, oh, it's a little bit much and I'm not going to be able to reach that. But keep aiming at that, because you know, if that's in the back of your mind to make that difference and make you who you know you really are, then it'll happen. Trust me. I've had 1 week in Hollywood and what's happened has been absolutely amazing. You know, people come here with hopes and dreams and visions in Hollywood to make it. I came here knowing that I already had. And that's the difference. So when I walked in here, I believed that this had already been done for me. So all I was doing was following the motion. So if we look at it that our life is already written out for us and it's perfect, and you act like that every day, every second, then it is, because it's like having your inner GPS. You program it, this is where you want to go. And when you've programmed it, you leave it. It says, this is where you're going to end up. Turn left, turn right, as Esther Hicks says in the Law of Attraction. So that's exactly what I've done. I've programmed in, this is where I want to be by Christmas. And then all the steps have just fallen in. So that allows me to step outside and say, well, I don't have to focus on where I'm going here, because it's already happened anyway. So what I'm doing is going with that flow and listening to the little things in the side. Like, oh, we can do this, can do that. Bloody brilliant life. Absolutely. Mwah. Mwah. God, I did that with no makeup on. That's scary.
That was perfect.
Oh, you've got
the funny thing is, it's actually, you know, it all sounds all great, and I'll be really honest with you here, there's been a whole lot of ups and downs. In fact, I really cry when I talk about it, because I went through a stage in life where I wanted to be perfect, but I listened to those around me who love me, and I'm going to cry now. And of course, well, when you think they love, but there's the pullers, you know, the people that just say, oh no, what do you want to do that for, darling? You know, you've got the kids at home and you've got that, and all my life I've been pulled back by people who love me. And it's such a shame, because we listen to that. You know who we need to love first? It's us. It's ourselves. When we love ourselves, then we have the courage and conviction to say, when someone says, I think you should do this, or you should do that, say, thank you, I appreciate what you've said, but I'm not going to listen. In fact, you maybe don't do it like that. Here's another way of looking at it. When somebody gives you a present, if you don't accept it, who owns the present? It's still theirs. So when people give you this, they look at it as a gift and you say, no, I'm sorry, I don't want it. Keep it. That's the key to making the difference. But let me tell you, I had days where I wanted to slash my wrist because of the mind chatter and all the things that go, you can't do it, you're not good enough, you're not smart enough, you've never had any training in this, blah, 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 blah. This was myself. My own worst enemy was me. And then, of course, when you're vulnerable and you listen to other people and they're saying, well, honey, you know, I don't know if you should be doing that, and that's not right for you. How do they know where I should be in life? I wasn't even sure. But when I followed my heart and what felt good, in fact, what is easy, what is really, really easy to do, you don't have to think about it. That's your flow. When you're in flow, everything is easy. Life's a joy. Business is a joy. I mean, some people get up and they love going to the florist and working in the florist every morning. Or they love getting out on the farm. Me? That sucks. So it's finding what that is for you, what that flow is, what is really easy and you do is a no-brainer. Some people love the stock market, going into real estate, whatever it is, find your key and follow that. Because if it's a job, it ain't working for you. And that isn't going to get you where you need to be at the end of the day. Okay. Now we've got to do the back of me.
Mm-hmm.
You know, really, what the show's about, you know, hi guys, I'm still just worried about this, because as I said, when I look at what's in front of the camera, I think, oh, it's a little bit boring, actually. But and I say that with all love to myself, because I don't want to, you know, put myself down, because I think I'm doing a great job. However, really what the show's about is, like I said earlier, it's behind the scenes, but behind the scenes to the point that it's the reality side of it. It's the crew and everyone here and what we do to put together a show. And I know Michael's wanted to groom me for the Tonight Show, but let me tell you, I'd find that really boring unless I can have some fun with it. So we're just saying, you know, imagine doing the show and all of a sudden, you know, I'm running late, come out, and Vera's following me doing my makeup live on the set, you know, it's like, and I'm doing an interview with someone and going, oh, sorry, I've got to, you know, and that's really what it's all about. That's that, you know, they're having fun. No one's doing that. That really sits with me. Really like the idea of that. So forget, don't you hide that shirt. Oh good, I need to go and hide it. Like, oh shit, I lost the blue one. There's only the green one. I'm wearing a blue top, that's all. This is where we've got one of the guests who spat the dummy, says, I want to wear the green shirt. My mate, my wardrobe lady says, no, I'm wearing blue. He has to wear blue. So, you know, now and then we get a guest, you know, walks around with a stick up his ass deciding that, you know, this is the way it's going to be. Well, let me tell you, boo. It ain't working that way, honey. Oh, God. Nothing worse than a guest with attitude.
Temperamental.
I don't want to do it this way. Oh, God. In fact, I'd like to do something crazy with guests like that. We need some practical jokes.
It makes you angry.
He's back in the room again. It's all right. We're just having fun.
Hi, hi. Yeah. Run.
Yes. Hey, you saying run and he was running.
The shy guest, put me on camera, but don't get me behind the scenes.
Can we get the AC
at
on?
At my age, I really don't care anymore.
Do you know
anymore.
How to turn it on? Is it hot in here, or is it me?
We're just having some fun. He snuck back here.
Close your eyes. Close your eyes.
Is it not okay for me to wear now, Miss Lady?
Miss Ketchum?
Yes, because I know what they're doing. Is it ready?
Yeah.
No.
This is one of my better looking guests.
They need to put extras on it, man. All kind of extras. I ain't the one. I'm easy to get along with. Hi.
That's
just my working over there.
So, how's it coming?